process that we started out with Medea ended up being something very, very different when we got into it. Traditionally, you take a show, and as a director, you generally block it out. You look at where people are going to move, how they're going to work in the set. And the problem with the Greek plays is that they're so old that there are pieces missing. The choruses generally danced and they sang, so there was a lot of music involved and a lot of movement involved in it, and we don't have any of that music, we don't have any of those steps. So I knew that there was a piece to the chorus that was completely missing, and I've been taking my schoolwork to heart, and I decided that we're going to devise some of that work. And so I did a little bit of the traditional blocking that you usually do going in, and then I went in with a couple of songs and not knowing what we were going to do with it. We decided to play, and that's kind of what we called it, is okay, let's play with this and see what comes out of it. There's an old theater saying that you don't work with animals and children, W.C. Fields. But I found them to be terrific. I was most worried that I would have, I would never be able to find children, because I would have parents who would say, "You want to do what with my kids? You want to cover them with blood?" And yeah, our parents were just terrific, terrific parents, and these were great kids. They'd worked together before. I was looking for little kids, which is also hard to do, because you have to have kids who are going to lie still for 10 minutes. And, you know, not scratch and not watch the audience, not misbehave, but be young enough that the audience really connects into the fact that these are little kids, that and they both love these children very much, and it's kind of hard to have a tickle fest with a teenager, but to have it on stage with a little child makes it just so much more poignant when Jason loses them. So I really did want little kids.
We finally settled on the little lights from the top that kind of gave the tin the actual sun color, like how it went from just dark to orange and yellow. And then we wanted to highlight the corrugation of the tin, where like it does the waves, so that red from the side helped give it something to make it 3D instead of a flat thing in the back. And then the texture scrape, the lines that went across it, actually started as we only wanted it on the paper, the horizontal paper, to kind of give it a little bit of looks, but someone accidentally knocked the boom and we put it on the wall, and Cherry liked it and I liked it, so that kind of happened by accident. But it looked super cool, and it kind of gave another aspect of what the sun looks like, where it has beams. So like the whole opening part was supposed to feel like we came up with so many names for the opening part. We did like pre-show, and we finally settled on the prologue, where no one's talking and it's everyone just running around. So that was the first thing we ever had to light, but I couldn't really put too much texture on them because all the texture was orange. So that was definitely a challenge in the beginning, making it not so blue that it looked flat. And then the scene with Cody, where he did the servant speech, it was real intense, and he was sitting inside the beam of the circle, and the only thing that was really on during that was the texture from the sides, the gobos, and then that top light. And that's the main part where we started the haze, because that was supposed to be like the magic happening, where like everything she's doing is coming to light, and then it would stay throughout the rest of the play for the final scene. And then obviously that scene at the end where it's the light just above all the pedestals, and the only thing that's on is that pedestal light, and then the sun for the big finale with the paper, which was the coolest.
Always knew that the set was going to be made of paper so that it could be destroyed every night, which was really exciting, but it was another one of those things that the actors and the directors were super thrilled about, and the stage managers went, "That's a lot of work. Okay, we'll figure it out." And we weren't in the studio for the first 2 weeks of rehearsal, so we were like crammed into 113, and like, imagine that there's papers here and 4 more feet of space. And so when we got into the studio, we had to reacclimate to that real estate and how much space we had to work with. And then when we finally got the paper, we had to reimagine everything as well, because the original plan for the paper was that the paper was utilized a lot more and was used to wrap the children and bury. And then once we got the paper and realized it makes noise and it doesn't fold easily and it's heavy and things drip and cost you, like, logistics came into play during tech. And so we really didn't figure out a definite paper plan until probably 2 days before opening. We were still kind of figuring out what was going to happen. And then once we got it settled, we had to figure out how to hang it and how to work that out. And sometimes it ripped, and then we had to figure out how to secretly tape it so no one could see. And the last two nights, everything ran smoothly, but I think those were the only two nights that we were like, nailed it.
Mm-hmm.
They're really fantastic kids, and they've luckily both done shows in live theater before, and so we didn't have to explain to them, like, quiet backstage and stuff like that. But I mean, it's an hour and a half show. They're children, so there was always a level of, like, use your inside voices, please rein it in, you know? But luckily, one of my ASMs became the designated children wrangler during showtime, and she tracked props as well as children during the rehearsal process. So when the kids got there, we knew exactly where they had to be, how much time they had to be off stage, and so there were even moments when she could take them downstairs to hang out in the dressing room for 10-15 minutes and then bring them back. And there was lots of, like, here's a coloring book, here's a Game Boy, here's a snack, you know, trying to keep them occupied. But they were real troopers, and they were only with us for the last, like, 2 weeks of rehearsals, but they caught on really quickly, and they were excited to be there, and they played dead and let people pour blood on them and didn't flinch. So I was completely satisfied with the experience altogether.